Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? Welcome back to Old Times. So, I have finished that field over there, which was field 5, the smaller one, and I have done some headlands on this field over here, field 2, and he's just stopped for a minute, so let's just go and start him up a second, and then we can watch him while I talk. And there we go. Right, and now all I need to do is H. Now this thing is absolutely fantastic. I didn't really follow him very much yesterday. We're just going to hang out of cab with the hired help on and just admire this beast of a machine doing the ploughing. It does a fantastic job. It is absolutely brilliant. I love it. Anyway, the question that I asked you last week was, do you want me to use that forestry mod in place, this forestry mod here, to sort of pass off as a Pika Model 75, and everybody, well, almost everybody, said yes. So we will be using that one. My question for today, though, is a little bit different. There is this mod here, and this was brought to my attention by McStallion, who has a long-term fan, and basically you've got all of these different structures. You've got the cell trigger, which is a diner that you can put in, but the style of all of these things looks to be pre-80s. So it's an older style, and I have carefully looked around the map, and you've got to place these on dead flat areas, otherwise they just float in the air. But I have found spaces to put them all. And basically you get water and milk with this tanker here, and I think you've got to actually stop milk sale for it to work properly. Then this one here, it produces beehives, and you've got to take it wood chips, or I think it's wood chips, or timber from a timber mod, but we don't have a timber mod in this one, and we probably won't. And then, so that they produce beehives from wood. I think you can use wood chips to do it as well. Then you get beehives in this one, you put the beehives here, and this one makes honey. You then take the honey and also cereals to this one and this one here. This is water and honey. So water and honey for that one, and this one is milk, water and honey, I think. But anyway, it doesn't really matter. Both of those, they create pallets of stuff that you can then eventually sell them at the diner over here. I think this is a brilliant mod. This is absolutely brilliant. It does cost a lot of money, but overall, I think this mod is absolutely fantastic. So I would like to be able to use that in this map. Once we've earned enough money to sort of cover these costs, we can just do it with one of them to start with. We got to have these three small ones here. And then one of those, so say that one there, and then we've got to have that one. So we're looking at 20, 40, 55, 255. So we want basically $250,000, euros, and then we'll be able to get it. But if you are happy for me to use that mod, I won't go into quite so much detail with it for the rest of the week, but that is the mod that I would like to use. And if you're happy for me to use it, head down below, let me know, yes or no, it's your vote, it's your game. Now then, just going to admire this one for a second longer. I did say that we were going to do some sugar beet today, but we have a slight problem with the sugar beet in that I've got a fantastic sugar beet harvester and I also have a potato harvester, but I cannot hire the sugar beet one. For some reason, the hire mod won't recognize that the sugar beet and potato harvesters are separate machines, and it won't let me hire them. So I'm going to have to buy the sugar beet one, even if I can get away with hiring the other one. I can get away with hiring the potato one, but I'm going to have to buy the sugar beet one. We don't have enough money to buy the sugar beet one, and the potatoes aren't yet ripe. So what we're going to do today is we're going to harvest the maize. So we'll go to our hire section, and it's that one there that we're going to need. So 1,000, that's almost all of our money. And then I need the header for that one, which is, it's got to be here somewhere, Rotzel Mash, that's all of those. The Lizard Maize Cutter is that one. This one right here, that is 96, rent. I'm assuming that didn't have a header trailer of any sort. No. Right. Okay, so let me go back. Those should be over in our yard, and we can run round and get those. I never actually thought about trying to climb up that wall. It's a little bit high. I don't think I'll be able to jump over that. So we've got the corn header, and we've got that. And this coin keeps coming back, and I'm slowly getting more and more coins. So I am wondering if everything is going to go horribly wrong soon. So this is saying that it's a lizard one, but originally giants didn't have licenses to make the other ones. This is actually a Deutz combine. It is almost identical to a Deutz combine. They've just called it lizard, that's all. But anyway, I'm going to get this one over to the field of maize, and I'm going to get those two trailers over there as well on a tractor so that we can get started on harvesting that maize. I just thought... I will show you a second. I did show you in the last episode of Melbury Estate, but in case some of you only watch this series, then I have another mod that I have installed on here that has been requested a few times by a few different people, so it has finally happened. So let me just turn round. Actually, let's have a look in cab a second. This is an ancient old machine with hardly any controls, but it does have a cab. There is that now. Oh yeah, of course, that just hitches straight on there, and then we climb out and you've got to look down here. I don't know if we're actually going to need to do it on here. I did put the mod on. Right, let me just try it with this tractor, because I'm going to use this tractor here to pull the hang on, let me pick up these eggs. Sorry, I'm kind of... I had things planned, and then I'm not doing them. So, I got distracted again. I know it happens. It happens a lot. You've probably seen this before. So, let's back up here, and we will go and get these trailers. And I should have this mod installed. Pretty sure I put it back into here. Now, we go over here. And it might be that it doesn't actually work on some of these older ones here. Now, that's looking a bit more promising. Come out here. It might just not have worked on there. Yes, there we go. See, it is the manual attachment mod. So we've actually got to do it like that. And yes, I would normally be able to just throw the trailers around with my brute strength, because I'm just that awesome. Yeah, okay. Right, let's get rid of that. And let's head off to our fields. Right, I'm here at the field. And I have actually got Auto Combine installed. I've been using it on some other maps. And I thought I might as well use it on this map as well. And have I got options for unfolding the header or anything? No, it just, that is the side that it is. So I've got the, yeah, like I said, I've got the Auto Combine. And I might, how much is going in? There we go. I'll keep it on for this field. I think it will work fairly well. I'm just going to drive around myself a little bit first so that we can have a look at this and see what it's like. I'm going to come out of cab a second so that we can sort of see some of the animations and the rest of it. It does look pretty good. It's a lot quieter than I was expecting. It doesn't really sound like a working combine, does it? But overall, I think it's okay. Well, we'll go a little bit further around the field, and then we'll engage the auto combine, and we can start filling up our trailers. Come round that bit there. We can just keep going in a straight line, I think. There we go. So I hope you don't mind me using the auto combine on this map. It is a really good mod. I really do like it. I've used it quite a bit now on the time-lapse map. You will see that in the next time-lapse episode. It's proved invaluable on that one. And I don't think it detracts from any quality of the game that we've had so far. It is kind of like realistic. The only thing I don't like is the way when you start moving up and down on the landwork. If you change it to do straight rows up and down, he does sort of put a kink in the end of the row each time, which is slightly frustrating because he won't do a straight line. But yeah, that's something you can live with. Now, come up to here, and if I just get that, and then back round. Am I going to be able to get once round this field? So I'm hoping that once we've combined this field, we will then be able to harvest potatoes. I'm hoping that they'll be ready to harvest by then, which means we can sell them direct. And if we're selling the potatoes direct, we can earn enough money then to be able to buy the sugar beet harvester so that we can harvest that field of sugar beet in there. And I haven't decided what we're going to plant in these fields yet either. We're going to have to plant something in here, obviously, but I'm not quite sure what it's going to be. I think we might, the field two that the Russian Kirovets is ploughing right now, I might put that one into either, well, it'd be one of these three crops that we've got over here. Actually, I might do that one as sugar beet. If I do that big field as sugar beet, and this field here that's had maize in it, this one could be, maybe barley? Oop. I'm rushing on too far. I'm not concentrating, so I've rushed on too fast because I ran out. I filled the tank up, and let me just put the arm out. Let's come out of cab. Well, that's the same sound and pretty much the same animation as the other one, but I've squashed a bit of crop. Okay, anyway, I'm going to go and get the tractor and trailer a second and bring those over. There we go, tractors. Or tractor and trailers. Going up through here. So, how long have we got? Oh! Ready to harvest. Okay, so the potatoes are ready. As soon as we finish this field, that means we can go straight on with the potatoes. Although we are minus 270 euros. So we are going to have to take out the final 5,000 on our loan. Because we had 5,000 there available before. Come underneath there. Is that in the right place? Just. Only just. I love the colour of the corn. Let's zoom out a little bit. Look at that colour. That's such a beautiful, rich colour of that one. And you don't actually... I'm from the UK, and we don't harvest very much of this like this. I know that it is quite common in the States. You do get quite a bit of it. But here in the UK, you do not see very much of this being combined. There is some, obviously there is some being combined, so I don't want everybody sort of leaping on me and saying, oi, what are you talking about? There, obviously, some of it is combined, but most maize that is grown in this country is grown for silage. It's harvested in September and October and turned into silage for cattle. But you don't see very much of it actually being combined like this, so you don't see that much of this really rich golden colour that we've got here. I think mainly because we just don't seem to have the hours of sunshine that are needed to bring the crop to its full ripeness. Right. I'm going to engage the auto combine now, and we'll see... Ooh, hang on, let me not engage that one for just a second. Close that one down. I want to come over to the end of the field. Let's just see what we've got. Great demand at Wassermühl corn. Excuse me. Okay. Right, that one's set okay. So what I'm going to do is get as much of this corn into... Maybe if we store it, we want to sell all of this corn in an hour. That's basically what we're going to want to do. And that's absolutely fantastic because it means that we can sell everything straight away. Let's put that onto auto combine. And we'll see how he gets on. I might just have him going round and round the field the whole time, actually. I'm just going to... We're going to watch him and admire how it works for a minute. But, yeah, if I... I'll put it into storage to start with. And then, once we've got all of it, we'll then concentrate on getting it to the sell point as fast as possible. We want to do that all in 1 hour. If we can get everything there in 1 hour... we should get the best price for it. Let's just check the prices, actually. How much are we going to get for this corn? This is brilliant. It's actually really, really awesome timing. Corn. Which one are we looking at? We want transport there. Wassermühl. Really? 167. That's, oh, that's terrible. Is that the actual price that he's now going to give me, or is that... I'm hoping that it's actually going to be more than that. Is that times 1.6? But, oh, that's... Yeah, please tell me that that's the, not the adjusted price. Right, okay. Let's just... We'll wait and see. I'm not sure if that's the actual price or not. If it is, that's not very much. Only 170 is... If that's the adjusted price, that's going to be awful. Have to wait and see. Right. Now, what's this one going to do? It backs up. It is really good at picking up everything in the field, but what I don't like is that it does sort of leave the corners out a little bit. It's not that accurate when it comes to picking up the corners. Is this this combine doesn't have anything to unfold, does it? There's no roof to lift up so that you can see into the grain tank. It's a little bit of a shame. It's not 100% accurate, but that, we can live with that. We can live with that. It is coming along quite nicely. Right, I'll tell you what. I'm going to cut a whole load more of this field and get a few trailerfuls and get that back to my farm, and then I will get back to you when we're nearing completion. Well, that's the first two trailerfuls. Actually, I want to go this way. Back around here. But yep, we've got two trailerfuls tipped, and the combine is going quite strongly. He's actually doing really well. He's quite a bit quicker than the other one, even though he's got the smaller corn header. I mean, the corn headers, they normally seem to take a little bit longer to harvest anything. So we might want to consider selling our other combine and buying this one. Although I have said previously that I'm reluctant to purchase any lizard combines or any lizard machinery unless I've absolutely got to. I would much rather go and buy the real thing. So what I might actually do is start looking around for a few other combine mods, old ones. I know there are loads of those. I said the same about the plows, but I know there are lots of combine mods. So I will start hunting around for some of those and see if we can get a slightly bigger combine on our farm soon. That would be pretty cool, because I'm really pleased with this one. This one's doing really well. Yeah, you remember when we were spreading fertilizer in this field? I thought that we wouldn't be able to go any further because it started damaging the crop. It turns out that after some testing, and it was pointed out by a couple of people, that it only actually damages the crop when we drive on it ourselves. So I could have actually finished spreading fertilizer in this field. So as it is, we got double yield on half the field and normal yield on the other half of the field, which is a bit of a shame. But at least we know now for next time what the cause of the problem was. It was simply because we were driving on ourselves. Hired help does not damage the crop, which is absolutely a fantastic thing to know. Well, we're working our way through this field, and I'm going to finish this field before the next episode. We don't really need to see a load more of this. The plough is working his way as well, so he will probably have finished field 2 before next episode, and I might start him on the next field. I'm not quite sure. It's going to take a while. It takes a little while to do the headlands out, which is a slight nuisance. So I may or may not start the next field prior to our next episode. I'm not quite sure, but I will finish this field. And then what we're going to do first thing next episode is we're going to sell all the corn that we get. We're at minus 1,500 so far because of having to use the hired help. So we may end up having to take out a loan anyway in spite of selling all the corn that we're going to get. We have got a reasonable amount of corn. So far we've got 15,500. And I really do hope that that is not the actual figure that we're going to get, because if it is, we're going to struggle. If you have a look on the map, where we've got to go is just down onto the island near the biomass heating plant. And soon we are going to go down there to do a little bit of forestry work. I would like to do some forestry work. We're going to use that peaker, but we won't be doing that next episode. Next episode, we will be hiring the potato harvester once we've sold all of our corn, and we will start on our potato harvest. And then hopefully after that, because we will be selling the potatoes direct, we'll be able to go on to the sugar beet. But the question that I asked you for today was, are you happy for me to use this beekeeping mod? All of these different pieces make up the beekeeping mod. I think it's absolutely brilliant. We will have a machine that we can use for carrying the pallets around with a pallet forks on it. I've got something lined up for that. But all of these different ones, they are absolutely brilliant. And then we can get that one, and then later on we'll also be able to get that one as well, so that we can get some more money from it. And all of these, they make up, they use the honey and the milk and the water and that, and they make up the pallets, and then we can sell them here at this diner. And I have found a few places that we can put these different mods around the map. I think it will be brilliant. I think it will fit in really well once we've got the money to be able to buy it, because it is really, really expensive. So, yeah, head down below, let me know what you think on that one. It's your vote, it's your game. I think that is really about it. I will continue on with this. So, thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed this episode, please head down below and give me a like. And if you really enjoyed it, then please tell your friends all about me. Get them to watch as well. That would be awesome. But until next time, thank you again for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye, and see you later.